Okay, this is my second time doing this because the first time didn't go so well. And one of the ones I was trying to record, apparently I had it working for a short time, but then I go to record it and the game won't start, so now I had to uninstall it and reinstall it many times until I get it to working, but that's whatever. As a result, I'm kind of behind on the games I want to record and show to you, but oh well, that's what happens. So this week, instead of actually going out and looking places, I actually got a GameCube game off of the internet, eBay. And I wasn't going to do that because I really don't like doing it because it's all overpriced and crap, but I sold it for what it actually should be, you know, what it costs and worth, and it's also in perfect condition, and there's that, and I thought it would come in time when I usually do go out and do that kind of stuff, so there's that. So I'll show you this first. Nightfire. One of my top favorite GameCube games. Yes, I know it's on the PlayStation 2 and Xbox and the computer. Computer version's horrible. The PlayStation 2 version suffers from bad frame rate and it's really just get the Xbox or the GameCube version. GameCube version is one I like. Everything's there. It's in perfectly fine condition. Do you have what it takes to be Bond? I had so much fun with this campaign, which is really good, but I like the multiplayer skirmish mode. In fact, I was playing it a little bit while I was waiting for this to do something. But then I had to start over. Everything is there. So that's nice. Eventually I might have to get everything off of eBay the way things are going. So that's out of the way. That's what I did. Now, I got something else in from Goodwill Hunter. Like I said, I already opened it and already tried doing this once over. Went a little too long and then problems started happening, so I gotta do this over. First we'll do this, of course. Burger Time with a Y. I like the game Burger Time, by the way, or Mr. Wimpy as it's also called in other places. Yeah, I'll read it to you and I'll show you. 8?2013. I've had those days. I've gone ahead and signed you up for the GoGo Hunter PC Game Month Club for the low, low price of only $14.99. Reminds me of what Jesse was making jokes about in Terraria with T-Bay. I doubt that's what he's talking about, though. Of which I don't intend to collect. Smiley face. Found some more obscure. I mean, one of them, yeah. Really obscure. But great PC games that weren't going to break the bank. I really would like to know who keeps dumping their collection at Goodwill, but won't complain. Goodwill Hunter. I think it's freaking D. He's tired of having all those old computer games surrounding him. I'm guessing. I don't know. I used to watch him. So there you go. Look, too close. And there you go. I don't eat hamburgers. Don't like them, but they're too soft. But that is a good, nicely drawn one. It looks better than some of the ones that I've seen in person at McDonald's and places like that. Those things look like heart attack on a bun. Anyway, so I'm going to show you the games. I got two visual aids for two of them, just to make it easier when I'm explaining. But first, let's do the most obscure one. This one, I couldn't record if I wanted to because it's a DOS game, so you already know the deal with that. I'm still working on a way I can do those, so I can show you the Star Trek game I got last time and a couple others. So it's going to take a while, but I'm still working on it. I mess with it each day trying to find a way, so I'm getting close. But here we go, Return to Zork. This is not the first game, obviously, but this is the sequel. I like this one better than the first one. I have played the first one, though. And not just on that little secret minigame thing they have in Call of Duty if you go to the computer. Made by a company that does not exist anymore. Infocom, but if you look underneath Infocom, an Activision company. Yes, before Activision went evil. An epic adventure in the Great Underground Empire. Now let's look at the back and you can get the story. Focus. The camera's not cooperating today either. Anyway, according to myth, the great underground empire of Zork was destroyed and all evil magic was dispersed. But now the IT&L Corporation claims to have discovered mythical dark recesses beneath the Valley of the Sparrows. Since their discovery, nightmares have become common, people vanished, buildings have disappeared, and you, the unwitting traveler, must save the underground empire from the forces of evil. Sounds a little bit like Myst, you gotta admit. This is something they used to do with old games. I was actually going to make a sure thing talking about this, but I never did. They used to promote and sell the games based on, like, designed by this guy, music done by him, from the people who made this, this and that. They don't do that anymore, though. This came out in 1993. I like the simple but cool-looking cover on it. No manual of any kind to speak of. And one disc. Thank you, Infocom. And you can see there, 1993. If it ever wants to focus. There it goes. 1993 Activision. IBM and 100% compatibles. Yes, it says compatibles. Plural. Whatever. So there's that. Now this is the one I actually had working for a short time today, and then it decided not to, so now I gotta play around with it. It does work though. I really love this series and this game. Many people consider 3 to be the best one, TB included. He can't talk enough about it. Whatever. All I know is to avoid, was 8? That one's bad. But anyway, you can actually get this and all the other ones off of GOG. Just saying. Might and Magic 6, The Mandate of Heaven. There's also Heroes of Might and Magic, but that's a little bit of an offshoot. Really nice looking picture on here. The artwork of this whole series is very reminiscent of Dungeons & Dragons, by the way. You even got a mage down there, you got a knight, got some dead dumb bard, and you got the archer. Whoop. Frame drop. Massive frame drop. Anyway, on the back here, you got kind of the same picture. New World Computing. And that was the problem I was having, by the way. Two discs both look exactly the same. It's got like this silk screen, pinkish red dragon on both of them. There you go. Came out in 1998. Works good, I just have to get it working again. Now this next one's interesting. And this is one I have a visual aid for. This one is the one that kind of surprised me out of the bunch. Well, Zork did, but whatever. Star Wars Monopoly, CD-ROM edition. I actually was playing this. This cannot be recorded. I tried. It does work. I got it working now. Again, this is one of the ones I have to come up with a different way of recording it. This isn't a DOS game, though, even though it's Windows 95. You want to do something funny? This is a Windows 95 game, right? I have a couple other Windows 95 games. Can't install those. Doesn't make sense, but this one does, right off the bat. No compatibility mode or anything like that. Made by now-defunct LucasArts, who I miss. They made some great shit. Let's be honest. Not so much towards their end, but, you know, whatever. This is very slow-going, but it's really cool. So, obviously, it's for Star Wars fans. But it's got some neat features, so let's check it out. As soon as it focuses. There you go. Classic Monopoly gameplay in immersive Star Wars universe. You can customize the rules, which is nice. Hosted by the original C-3PO, Anthony Daniels. Yes, that's true. He talks throughout the entire thing. He says, like, Luke Skywalker is now paying debt. And he also says little funny things for the FMVs that show for each thing you do. It's a very slow-moving version of Monopoly. It's the best way I can put it. There we go. I just wanted to get a little bit sharper. There you go. Choose from 1 of 8 full motion. Oh, yeah, can't forget that. 3D Star Wars Heroes Villains. Like, you can be Chewbacca, Han Solo, Luke Skywalker, Vader, Boba Fett, a Stormtrooper, and a couple others I can't remember. Oh, yeah, and R2-D2. Buy and sell your favorite Star Wars properties. They just basically replace what the normal Monopoly board is. If you know where the places are on that, you know the same thing as here. They just got different names and pictures. View hundreds of movie scenes in a very small, compressed, highly compressed FMV from the Star Wars trilogy. That is the original good Star Wars. Play worldwide over the internet. Yes, you can actually play this online, but not anymore because all these old games use their own online thing. This one being Internet Gaming Zone, which does not work anymore. There's Boba Fett. That is kind of what it looks like, except for they jump and skip across the places. Monopolize the galaxy. You know, if some companies were able to, I bet they would. So there you go. And the manual is pretty thick because it has all the rules and all that kind of stuff. Whoop. You have to have the CD in to play it, unfortunately. K to A, I would hope so. I don't know if Monopoly should be rated mature. I don't know why. And I got some other board games they have on CD. They don't show Clue here, which is weird. It's how I played Clue first on the computer. That's the one I used to have, all the way on the right. I have the case, but I don't know what happened to the CD. Normal Monopoly. Risk, which is a really fun game. I saw Metal Gear Solid Risk once, by the way. I wish I got it. I got no one to play, though. And Scrabble, which I have a version of that. Normal, it doesn't look like that. The real board game, and again, I can't get anyone to play with me. Now, speaking of the visual aid I mentioned, this is basically this in game form. Remember I showed this quite a while ago? I need to remake that video because I have a better camera than I did back then, and mic, but yeah. Basically the same exact thing as this. So there's that. Now the last game that came in. I actually technically already have this, but the version I have doesn't work right because of how they made it. I've shown this before. Temple of Elemental Evil, right there. This has frame rate issues, that's why I never tried recording it. Here's the real game. I love boxes like this, by the way. They have a little flip thing out. It's the Balrog. No, I'm not kidding. It really is the Balrog. And we have a female Gandalf right here. I always love it when they have these little things you can open. This is based in one of my top two favorite D&D campaigns. Remember, as I keep saying every now and then, I've never played the actual D&D tabletop game. But I've played many video game adaptations, my favorite being Neverwinter Nights, which I have Forgotten Realms, but it doesn't work anymore. It's like the CDs or disease, whatever computer I put it in fucks it up. Anyway, I love this game. It's different role-playing game, the way it works. It's got radial menus. I'll record this sometime, but like I said, I got to figure out some other problems I'm having right now before I get to this. I've been meaning to do this for a while, but at least now I can do it without frame rate problems. Based in the, as soon as it focuses, Greyhawk campaign, which is really nice. It's cool too, you get these FMVs for when things happen, and you got basically a DM, like if you were to play a real D&D game, explain like what the story is, you're going here, you're doing this, you're talking to this guy. It's really cool. RPG heaven, you damn right it is. This is also on GOG, by the way. I figured I might as well mention that. I don't think, Return to Zork isn't yet. And that Star Wars Monopoly definitely isn't. No Star Wars games are on GOG yet. For the first time ever, one of the greatest Dungeons & Dragons adventures of all time comes to life on PC. This is probably the one I'd actually want to play on the real D&D if I was ever to play it. As I said before, there is a place not far from me. They do it like every Thursday. I just need this shit I need. The AD&D book I have is out of date, but whatever. First and only PC game to feature D&D 3.5 rule set. First of all, that's not true because there's some that came after this that use it, but of course they can't see into the future. That's the rule set I like, at least playing video game versions that use D&D rules. I don't like 4. A lot of people don't like 4. I found that out from watching Spoonie. Apparently he said people flipped their shit when rule 4 came out. Creep parties up to 5 adventurers, well, up to 3 followers. Yeah, that's nice. You can have a different variation of who you have with you. Dozens of skills, class abilities, over 50 feats, and hundreds of spells, multiple starting points, quest solutions, depending on the party's alignment. That's really fun. That gives the game a high level of replayability. More than 100 different monsters, from goblins and hill giants to elementals and demons, and as you saw, the Balrog. And there's some pictures of what the game looks like. It's a lot cooler in motion, obviously. Manual's really thick and it's binded, just like the one I have for Neverwinter Nights, and Star Wars Galaxies don't have the game anymore, but I have the manual. Whatever. So that's it. I got the GameCube game, and these are the ones GWHUNT3R sent me. Again, thanks. And I'm working on a way to record the DOS games, and I'll get around to recording and showing all these other ones I've gotten. It just takes time to figure out because they're older and they're harder to record. It's kind of out of my control as far as that goes. So thanks for watching. I will see you next time. And I'm thinking today I might actually do the video on Temple of Elemental Evil. I'm not going to bother with the tutorial, even though it's a really well done tutorial and you can choose not to do it, which I appreciate. It's just not interesting. So I don't think you want to watch the tutorial anyway. So thanks for watching, and I will see you later on. I also have an NBA Jam video I want to do, so that should be funny. You'll see. Adios.